Welcome back to my channel. So I am very excited today. You might be like, why, Tanisha? Why are you excited? What are we going to talk about that's making you so excited? Well, guess what? I got some. Cookies in the oven. Cookies. I've been working on my little pop lop thing. I can't get past right here. I can't go the, like, what? Something happens on this side of my body. The left side has no coordination. I can't snap with my left hand. I can't wink with my left eye. Nothing on the left side works properly. I'm all right bodied. Right side. Anyway, okay, so today is gonna be a fun video because I'm gonna be discussing in detail my favorite products, my staples, my holy grails, whatever you wanna call them. I'm covering all of that. I'm gonna cover shampoo, conditioner, deep conditioner, leave-in conditioner, oil, liquid, cream, gel. Those are what I'm gonna cover. Oh, and a styler. So, shampoo. Let's start off at the top with shampoo. Bam. This is the Niaxin number 5 shampoo. Okay, this is for people who are experiencing hair loss. As you know, I have a hair loss journey that I have been going through and have gone through. And so this was my holy grail shampoo at the time. Right now, that I'm no longer losing hair, I'm not using this. And I can honestly say I don't have a favorite shampoo right now, so I apologize for that. But before, like 2 months ago, this was what I used regularly. And I used the matching conditioner to this. Right now, for my wash and goes, which I do daily, this is my conditioner. It is the Herbal Essences Hello Hydration. I tried the Totally Twisted one. I tried it. Didn't like it as much as this one. So this one's a staple. This thing right here is about $6 at Walmart. Totally worth it. Okay? Totally worth it. Next, deep conditioners. I love the Shea Moisture deep conditioners. My favorite one is the Hanukkah and Minoy. Manuka and Hanoi, honey and Manuka. I need to do better. I'm gonna post below what my favorite one is. This one's okay, but my favorite one is the one that you see below. Okay. I usually add a little bit of oil to this, slather it in my hair, put a cap on, walk around the house for 30 minutes, vacuum, sweep, whatever, call it a day. Leave-ins, these two bad boys right here. Literally been using this for years. It's like $3.99. Sometimes it goes down to $2.99. Sometimes you can get a double pack for like $6.99. It's totally worth the money. They have a couple of different kinds. There's a new one that came out, the Whole Blends one, and there's an orange one that came out. I'm stuck on this one. One, because it does its job, and two, because it smells so good. Have y'all smelled this? Smell it. Smell it. It smells really good. And then this one is the Oyen Juices and Berries. This is a little bit pricier. I paid about $13 for it at Target. But it also smells great and it gets the job done. Love it. There's so many great things in this, I'm sure. Nourishing herbal tonic. Leave-in. Oh, nourishing herbal leave-in hair tonic. So, it's a good one. Oil. Go-to oil, always has been, is coconut oil. This is the 100% organic, extra virgin, pure, unrefined, cold-pressed coconut oil. Girl. Boy. Man, woman, anyone who's watching this stuff is awesome. I love it because it's really lightweight, and at 76 degrees, it turns into a liquid. Anything below that, it will coagulate and become a solid. So the only issue you might run into with this is the fact that in the wintertime, it will coagulate in your hair. So your hair will be nice and firm. When you go inside in the heater, it gets soft again, so it doesn't matter, right? And also, I used to love it because when my hair was longer and I had like the bomb twist out that was super, super defined, when the wind would blow outside, my curls would be locked in place. And when I go inside, they get back all fluffy and light. Some people don't like that, but I honestly love that about coconut oil. This is the gel that I use, the Eco Styler styling gel, professional styling gel with coconut oil in it, go figure. And what I like about this one is that it actually stimulates hair growth, promotes hair health, adds luster, shine, and softness. I truly believe that. I can tell the difference when I switch to something else. And it says contributes to hair length. I don't even do length checks. Maybe I should start doing that for y'all. So I really couldn't tell you if I felt like it's done that, but my hair is growing, but that's what hair does, so My current favorite styler, it's between this and a Talia Wajid product that I really like, her curl cream, but this is the Cantu Shea Butter Coconut Curling Cream. This stuff is awesome. It's a little thick. If you prefer something that's a little thinner, then you might try the custard if you don't mind custards. I'm not a big custard fan, to be completely honest, especially not in the summer because they like never dry. But this stuff is amazing. Smells great. Holds my curls very well. It holds my styles very well, so I love it. As far as my tools, these are my main tools. Right now, I detangle with a rat tail comb. I keep one in the shower, and when I have conditioner in, I just go through like this. It cuts through like butter. My hair is just too short to be using this thing right now. But before, I was using this, which is a tortoise shell detangling comb. And then this is a pick that I use on a daily basis. Yes, it is missing a tooth. But I use this to pick my curls out, especially because as they've gotten a little longer, what I find is that after I've sponged them, some of them will get kind of smushed. So I'll just go in and I will just pick. Don't pull through because you just pull the curl out, but just, you know, kind of lift at the root. This is my go-to brush. I've had this brush for years. It is a boar bristle brush. Very important. Ladies, those hard plastic kind that your mama used to scrape your forehead and be brushing your eyes and stuff with, that is not the kind that's supposed to be used for your hair. You need a boar bristle brush. No. It is not as strong. It is not as sturdy. It's not going to get your hair as slick, but that's what your scarf is for. You're not supposed to brush your hair into submission to the point where you're ripping your hair out at the root. Like, don't do that. So use this, okay? And then use a scarf to catch those flyaways, and you're good. And your little toothbrush on the baby hairs, and you are Gucci. I also use a Demon brush. Don't have it here right now with me, but I will post a picture of it. The Demon brush was my go-to when my hair was longer. Right now, the Demon brush wouldn't really do me any good, but it used to really make my curls clump together, which is what I really loved. I got my cookies. Also, for any of my curlies out there who might have issues with hair loss or have experienced it in the past or currently going through it, just so you know, if you up your protein, that is highly beneficial to you. And I'm talking about the protein you intake in your body. Protein shakes, eggs, any type of meat that's high in protein, your fish and your chicken and that sort of thing. Get that in your body to kind of give your hair a jump start. Another thing that I really liked was the Biotin and Collagen Spray by Organics. And also, Carol's Daughter has a protein spray, which was also very instrumental to me. Wild Growth Oil is also one of my big faves. This is what the Wild Growth Oil looks like. It's $9. You can get it at almost any beauty supply store. Yes, it is worth the money. Absolutely. Now I have a surprise for you. Come here, Toot. Come here, Roxy. Anyway, I wanted to show you Roxy's hair routine for those of you who might be pet lovers out there and want to know. So here she is. She uses the Viva La Dog Spa Oatmeal Dog Shampoo. This stuff is great for dogs with sensitive skin. Roxy gets a bath every 2 weeks, by the way. And then she gets her nails clipped every 2 weeks. And she gets her ears cleaned every 2 weeks, just so you know. I use the little Q-tips that have the built-in witch hazel, vitamin E, those. The ones for dog's ears. Cat's ears. She uses cat ear cleaner, but she doesn't know that. So this is her shampoo that she uses. Conditioner. This is her conditioner. Yes, conditioner does work on dogs just like it does on humans. It really makes her hair really soft. I can tell the difference. So, and it was only $1, so totally worth it. Also, you can use VO5 conditioner as well. I just grabbed something that smelled good. This is Ocean Breeze. Then, y'all know Bedhead, that brand? This is Pethead, okay? This is Roxy's leave-in conditioner. It smells amazing. It's strawberry, right? Strawberry yogurt. Smells so good. Smells delicious. And I put it on after she gets out of the tub. And then afterwards, I spray on her cucumber melon grooming spritz. Okay, she needs her perfume. Don't you? Girl! She uses a shampoo, a conditioner, a leave-in conditioner, and a perfume spray. So that's all I have for you today. I hope you all enjoyed my video. Just so you know, I had a request for a facial routine, like a skincare routine. I know in my very first video, which wasn't that long ago, my second first video, right, the one in 2017, I explained that I was going to keep this beauty channel. It's going to stay a beauty channel for now. I'm not going to go into the lifestyle, even though I want to, and that I was going to stick to hair tutorials. However, that one's kind of highly requested, so I'm thinking about bringing that to you all next week. So if you're all right with it, I just want you to know that you may actually see a skincare routine video from me coming up. So please let me know in the comments. I'd love your feedback. I love to hear what you want to see and what you don't want to see. All that stuff's really important to me because I want to give you what you want. So hope you enjoyed today's video. I'll see you next week. Bye.